Welcome everyone to my Let's Play, or not really a Let's Play, my tutorial series about Farming Simulator 2019. Let me turn down the music volume because it's very loud. Okay, that's better. Okay, so what we are going to do is we're going through the tutorials first, and what I mainly want to do is, you can see I did almost all of them. I'm a beginner of the Farming Simulator series myself, and I still found it sometimes difficult to understand some things in the tutorials. So what I want to do is go through the tutorials and I will give some extra explanations, and maybe after that we can do a playthrough in which I explain all of the things better. So we start with the arable farming tutorial. So what you have to realize is that the Farming Simulator is a kind of 3D environment game, and you control the tractor and the machinery, and you process the land in that way. But what's really important to know is that you really do not have to go through each field manually. There are workers in the game, which we'll come to later, but for me that was really an eye-opener, because I first thought, oh, do you have to go through each field manually? That will be a chore to do, will be boring, but that's not the case. Okay, so in this first tutorial, they just explain you first cultivate the land, then you sow it, and then you harvest. So we start with the cultivation, and then you need a tractor and a cultivator. Okay, first look around. Well, I'm playing with a controller. I heard there are some controller problems with some players, but I think, well, I don't have many problems with it. Only in the menus, it's sometimes acting a bit weird. Okay, so the basic thing is that if you have a tractor, it can, you can attach certain things to it. You first have to enter the tractor, so we enter the people. Can I go to the menu? No, I can't, because the volume is very loud. So here is the gas pedal, and next to it the brake. And you've seen the steering wheel before, haven't you? It's easy. So you can accelerate and steer it. So you need to attach the weight and the cultivator. So you have the thing is that if you attach the cultivator at the back, it's a high weight. So you also have to attach a weight in the front of the tractor, because then you balance it out. So I look around and you can see here in the front you have the weight. Okay. And the controls are always in the upper left corner of the screen, so that's really handy to know. So we attach by pressing A. The other thing, another thing that's really, press A, and we attach the weight. And if you now press A again, this is on my Xbox One controller, the control view will maybe be different. You have attached the cultivator. And now what they explain is that if you have two tools attached, you can switch between them by pressing a certain button. In this case, for me, it's the Y button. And so what you also can do in the tutorials, I thought there was a button. Oh, I'm out of the vehicle. Oh, I'm messing up a bit. But open or close tutorial menu. Okay, I press that button, I thought. Ah, yeah. Okay, it's over here. So here you can read back the steps. So the cultivating is just loosening the soil, and then you make it well prepared for sowing. And so what we are going to do is cultivate, and we have to drive up and down the field. And we have to select a cultivator at the back and lower it into the soil. And then drive up and down the field as straight as you can. Okay. Select the tool. And this is also something I was just confused myself with. If you look at the top of the screen and then at the left, so you have there on the top left you have controls, and then a bit to the right you have a tranquil display. If you press on the select tool key, you switch between the tool. So now it's the front is selected and now the back. What we have to do is, we have selected it, then we can press another button. For me it's the left button, the right button is to honk, like this. But you can also press the left button and then we can hold and lower the cultivator. What we have to do is to lower it. So we press B. And now we have to drive up about the land. So we give some gas. So this thing you only have to do a little bit because you can use workers later on. And that's really, as I said, for me it was really an eye-opener. Because you really don't need to drive around the land on all fields. It would be really boring. Okay, I'm not that much of a good driver, but I'm not such a good driver, I have to say, but also you shouldn't be worried about the I mean, on Steam the reviews aren't that positive always, but I mean there are just a few things. There are bugs apparently, but they will fix all those bugs. And the second thing is, okay, in the 2017 version you have mods. Of course you don't have all these mods yet in the 2019 version. So I think if you decide on what you want to buy, you should really buy this new version. But of course you can also buy both, whatever you want. But it's if you are just if you are in doubt which you need to buy, and if you are scared, well, scared is a bit big word, but if you are a bit in doubt because of the negative reviews, I can say that I posted a topic on Steam and most of them really said that you should buy the 2019 version. Because in the end they will fix all the bugs, there will be more, and in the end it will be a much better game. Is it alone for the graphics? It looks better. That's one thing. And also gameplay wise there are some changes. But it's really annoying that you get that message over there. And sorry, I have to do something about that message, so that's why I am okay, that's done. That was the last message we will get. Okay, we got the hang of cultivation. Ready to plant some seeds. Of course we are ready to plant some seeds. So we have now loosened the soil and now we can sow. Get in the tractor and attach the tools. Okay. So you see here's the sowing machine. This is the sowing machine. Here are the seeds. And this is the tractor. And we have attached the tools. Let's drive a bit backwards. And you see immediately at the bottom of the screen it appears that you can attach this tool. Okay, so we first have to fill the machine with sows, the seeds. Okay, these are canola seeds. Okay, so we move to the back. And refill the sower. You see that in the left screen. So you press the button to refill the sower. So we have loaded the seeds, and now we have to. So I have to press again the button with the action. So that's the left button of my controller. I lower the sower and I turn it on now. And now we can start with the sowing process. And let's see. You can also see it here in the back. You see the land has turned a bit in a different color. So drive around the land, and I think this is a bit it's a bit boring probably to watch this process, but I'm not that good yet in video editing, so maybe you should skip through this part. And it's also not that easy, I find, to drive in straight. Oh, well, now I'm going kind of well, but that's also handy with this worker, because they drive perfectly, almost. I think there were some bugs with these workers, but yeah, okay, that will be fixed. I'm confident that it will be fixed. I mean, I heard that also 2017 version had a lot of bugs, so this will be fixed, I guess. And I really like that you can download all the Spotify, okay, not yet, but in the end you will get a lot of mods, and it's really a great game to pick up, I think. Because this game also has some economics, so it's not only driving here on the field, and it's not kind of simulating that way, it's also simulating that you manage a company and that you decide which fields to buy, etc. So the seeds are planted, and now it takes time to grow them into a canola. Okay, so after some time has passed, and you can set this time, I can't access the screen yet, but you can change the speed of the time in game. And this is very important, because the default speed, and I can show this in another tutorial, is set at times 5, but I advise you to set it at real time in the beginning. So you need a combine harvester and a header for this task. And the combine harvester harvests the grain and separates it from the stems. And then the grain can be sold. Okay, so we have to combine the harvester, the combine harvester, and attach the header at the front. Okay, so this is the harvester, combine harvester, and this is the head. So if you see here, if you walk to this field, you see here it's owned by me. Fruit type is canola, it's ready to harvest, it's 100% fertilized. We didn't do that. Actually, there's no wheat, it needs plowing and it needs lime, okay. But we can harvest it, so that's great. And what we will do now is enter the vehicle. And we drive a bit forward. We have attached it. First, a combine must be unfolded, and then we can turn it on. And it will be loaded automatically. For harvesting you have to keep it locked. Okay, so remember that we have to press the left button again, we unfold it, lower it and turn it on. So we press the A button to unfold it, we lower the header and we turn on the harvester. So let's get harvesting. the bottom right of the screen, you can see how much we have harvested already, and you can see the speed, etc. And in the bottom left, of course, you see the map. Also, you have different camera views. Well, I'm always playing in this mode, but I can, for example, if you drive in this mode, you are kind of inside the machinery itself, which is also kind of nice. It's depends on what you prefer, of course. I prefer this view, but it doesn't. I mean, some people, a lot of people, play with steering wheels. That's probably better. Okay, we are done. Oh, the combustion thing is nearly full. Open the pipe and we drive alongside the tipper at the edge of the field. And the train tank entrance. Okay, so what we have to do, if you look at the bottom right, you see our machinery is almost full of the grain. So we have to leave it somewhere. You see there in the back, we have some kind of truck. Where we can put it in. So we will drive towards that. This looks a bit ugly, but of course we can turn this thing off, for example. So we turn, it's already turned. It's automatically turned off. Okay, but I have to. You see, at the left side is my pipe, so I have to drive in such a way that I'm not so good at driving. I can explain this game, but driving, you really need to learn yourself. Some people say it's made for mouse and keyboard. I actually don't know, but okay. Now we select the tool. We already have the right tool. As you see, we can also select the tractor, but we select the, this is not the tractor, but in the image in the top left, it's not really in the left, it's in the top, besides controls, you see it switches between the tractor and the front. Okay, so the front, the pipe, we select now the pipe out. Okay, so we need to drive a bit in this way and maybe to the right. Well, as I said, I'm not that good in driving. But you have to make sure that this pipe is above this truck thing. As you can see, the truck fills with grain. So I really got a lot of it. Okay. Great. Get out of the combine and get into the tractor. Okay. So what we do now is we get out of this machine and we get into our tractor. And we enter. And if you look at the lower left of the screen, you can also increase the map. Drive over there and we empty it in the silo. So you see something flashing over there. And we have to bring the grain over there. It's not that far, it's already here on the left. And if I press the right button plus Y, we are going to unload it. Or start overloading. It's not really working, right? Y. Oh, I did Maybe it says it won't be. Oh, testing the lights now. Looks a bit relevant. Excellent. The grain will be balanced in silos. There's a limited capacity. And once I'm ready to sell it, then you can take the grain out of the silo and deliver them to one of the various selling stations in the world to make some money. So this was the first tutorial, and there are a lot more. Well, if you see, I didn't do all of them because I think if you get the hang of these basic steps, well, you can go on further. So we will go through some of the tutorials, but I'm not sure if we do everything. We go to crop protection, and so you can have weeds, and we can remove them. So that's what we're going to do now. But in the end, the basics often are the same, like you attach a tool and... I mean, okay, so we can remove weeds using a weeder or a sprayer. So once the plants have sprouted, you can remove the weeds by using a weeder in the early growth stages. Be careful that they don't grow too tall. So we go in the tractor. So this is the weeder, and we get in the tractor, we attach it, and we see here in the field lots of weeds. We also have to attach this block in front, so we drive forward and attach it. Now we have to unfold the weeder and lower it to the ground, and then we just drive over. I mean, this is in the end, if you know how all these menus work, you kind of know how to play or operate in this game, because it's always the same. I have this tool. Okay, then I'm thinking, which tool do I need to select? I want to select the weeder. So I look at the tracker image after to the right controls screen. Then I see, okay, my front is select. That's not okay. I need to select the back. So I press Y, and then I press the left button, and I can unfold and lower it. So now we unfold it. We unfold it, it's very big, you see, and then we lower the weeder. So that's why. And you can see that the weeds are removed from the land, from the field. I'm Dutch, so maybe my pronunciation isn't correct, or pronunciation, but I hope you understand what I mean. Okay, so we drive around. Oh, we can also drive this way, of course. It's not that neat, but I'm always using those workers. They cost money, these workers, but I think you can do without them. It's of course nice sometimes to drive around, but in the end, managing all the fields without the workers is too boring for me. But I really like how it is right now with these workers. Also, in the 2017 version, you have workers, so it's not like that would be the reason to go to 2019, but I think also looks much better. This 2019 looks much better than 2007. And personally, I didn't have much trouble with the 2019 version. But I'm a beginner, so maybe I don't see the gameplay bugs that well. But in the end, I didn't have any crashes or something, so it plays very well. Okay, so now we have got the rid of the weeds. Okay, but sometimes we are too late, and then we have to use a sprayer and apply plant protection. So here you can see this is the kind of chemical stuff, I guess. I'm not sure. As you can see, it also shows here. If you are kind of blind, then you can see that there is weed in the lower screen, lower right. 100%. It's not fertilized, it's growing. You see all the also this all these plants. So it's clearly that the weed is too high. And then we can use this sprayer. And with this kind of chemical stuff. I'm not sure what it is. Okay, so we attach that thing. Okay, for the sprayer, we have to fill it with the herbicide and then turn it on and drive over the field. So we actually know all that stuff, like the driving, but I'm too far. And okay, I have to refill the sprayer. You also always have to look clearly, refill the sprayer. I don't see anything happen, but I guess it's getting refilled. And let be unfolded, lower it and turn it on. We unfold it. We lower it and turn it on. We first need to unfold our skill unfolding. And we turn it on. So it's spraying. Do we get to see anything? Yes. As you can see, if you're not colorblind, you can see that all of the weeds are getting a purple color. Let's see if there's nothing left anymore in this tutorial, so I will quit this tutorial right now because it's a bit annoying to... it's not annoying, but I mean we have something more to do. So that's the crop protection fertilizer. It's also an important topic, so I will not skip this tutorial. I want to go fast through these tutorials, but yeah, it takes time. Fertilizing is just that you give it more nutrition, kind of. And that grows better. And so to improve the crop yield, it improves your crop yield. And there are many ways. You can use a manure spreader, a slurry tank or a fertilizer spreader. And the manure and the slurry, they come from your cows and your pigs. So you can also have animals in this game. And manufactured fertilizer, salt or liquid. Okay, I'm sorry. So you can buy manufactured fertilizer, can you buy from the shop. So in this tutorial you see we have different tools. You have, I think this is the, what's this? Well, let's get started. First get in the tractor. And I'm not sure what they want me to do first. Let's see. Okay, I have to attach the tool. This is a bit weird how they explain it, but make sure to unfold the tool, then turn it on. Olly's radish is a catch crop, which is a fast growing crop you plant before. Okay, so I have to go to the tool. We only do one. I mean, this is just basically the same as all the other tutorials. But we will do one of them. Because you have to drive to. But basically, I mean, it's the same. I mean, you probably see it already. It's all the same a bit. You drive around on the field. I don't mean to say that this is boring. Exactly not. Because you have a whole management aspect in this game. And we can attach the tool. And why did I get out of the vehicle? Oh, I probably pressed the wrong button. So make sure to, so we have turned, we turn the slurry tank on, but not now. First we dry it on here and then we turn it on. We turn on the slurry tank. And do you see anything? No. You see something coming out of this, but you don't actually see this. You don't see this on the field. But actually, you can get out of it. It's 0% fertilized. Oh no, you see, it's now, it's just counting or something, 27%. So it's partly fertilized. Okay, I won't go through this tutorial entirely, but this is just one of the fertilizers. And there's another one, which you can read over here, and that's oilseed radish, which is a catch crop. And you plant it before the crop you intend to harvest. And once the radishes have started growing, you need to break and burrow them into the ground with a cultivator. And that cultivator, which was the machine we used in the first tutorial, and destroys them, but adds a lot of organic matter and nutrients to the soil. And try it, go to your tractor, attach the weight and cultivator and cultivate. Okay, but we are not going to do that. I mean, it's all the same, really. This fertilizer soil care. Okay, let's go to the soil care. What they have to say about that. But I think you can get started pretty well with this tutorial. And that's the main thing of this, to get you started and to know some extra tips. And this is the soil care lesson. So for example, after 3 harvest cycles, your field needs lime. And it can be bought in the shop. So as usual, so go to your tractor, attach the weight and the spreader, etc, etc. We're not going to do this, it's all the same. As you see, then they also say that after harvesting corn, potatoes, sugar beet and sugar cane, you also have to plow the field. So then you go plow. I mean, it's all the same. I want to end it because it's all the same. I didn't do the baling. We can do it, and you have forestry. Let's do it just to, for completeness sake. Baling is, I'm not sure, I didn't do this tutorial. It's a shame on me. But the baling is that you drive around the field and that you get the bales. Depending on your baler, you can create round or square bales. And then the hay is obtained by mowing the grass and drying it. It used to feed your cows or sheep. And then the straw is obtained after harvesting wheat or barley. It's used as bedding for your pigs and your cows. Let's make some square straw bales. Get in the tractor and attach the baler. Okay. So, let's read in this tutorial. Yeah, you also you get some bales on the land, so we get into the vehicle. We drive backwards. Now unfold the tool and lower the pickup. Then turn it on and drive over the window to collect the straw and create your bales. So I need to unfold it, lower it and turn it on. And this is actually one of the nicest things, in my opinion, because if you drive here, you will see bales getting created. Take some time, but yeah, I think the first bale. No, what's wrong? I don't see any. Where is this going? Oh, that's weird. I think I'm doing something wrong over here. Let's see. Let's read in the manual. So, unfold the tool and lower the pickup. Then turn it on and drive over the window to collect the straw and create your bale. Turn it off. Turn it on. Unload the bale. Okay, that's what they don't tell you in the tutorial. You have to unload the bale. As you can see, I can get out. You see? You create these bales. Yeah, so you create these bales. You can even pick them up, I think, but it's too heavy. Then watch in the tutorial. So you know to pick up the bales and transport them. They use a front loader, a bale spike, and a bale trailer, a bale collector, which is simplifying the thing. And then you have to go on your map to sell the bales. But we will quit this tutorial. The last tutorial is forestry. And that's about cutting down the trees. So, you learn to plant trees, fell trees, and transport and sell wood. Okay, well, this looks beautiful, by the way. This is a beautiful view. I mean, this is a very large field, right? Isn't it? Okay, I'm not going to do this entire tutorial, because I think we're already long in it. But the main thing here is that you can cut down trees and etc. I think you can go over this alone. And the basic thing is that you now know all the basics. Okay, and what I want to do next is I want to go through some kind of playthrough. But I'm going to do a let's play on... I don't want to start this. I'm going to do a let's play in the tutorial-ish style. And I hope you will enjoy that, because I'm also still learning this game, but I will share all the information that I get and find. And yeah, that's it for now. I thank you all for watching, and in the next videos I'm going to do a let's play of Farming Simulator. So thank you all for watching. Leave down below some comments if you would like, and have a good day. Bye bye.